Hello friends. In the previous video, we saw some interesting examples of identifying angles with Bholu and Golu and measuring angles with the help of a protractor. In this video, we'll see some common mistakes associated with angle identification and measurement. Both Golu and Bholu were trying to solve the same question, but their answers were coming different. According to Bholu, the measurement of this angle is more than 30 degrees. And according to Golu, the measurement of this angle is less than 30 degrees. Both of them went to their uncle to find out whose answer is correct.
Uncle, how can there be two different measurements of the same angle?
This cannot be possible, Golu. Perhaps both of you may not have measured the angle correctly. Can you show me again how you measured the angle?
Golu and Bholu showed their uncle the measurements of the angle. This time Bholu's measurement was more than 30 degrees and Golu's measurement was less than 30 degrees. Can you tell that which answer is correct? If you want, you can pause the video here and think for a while.
Bholu's answer is absolutely correct.
But how is that, uncle?
Look, kids. To measure angles, we need to make sure where the center point of the protractor is placed. This center point has to be placed at the vertex of the angle, and this arm should be aligned with the baseline of the protractor. Only then will our answer be right. So tell me, what is the measurement of this angle now?
It is more than 30 degrees.
Yes, you are right. But if they are not aligned, then our answer will be wrong. Therefore, one always has to take care of the center point and the baseline.
Okay, uncle. Now I understand how to measure an angle accurately.
Come on, kids. Now let me ask you a question. Can you tell which of these angles is greater?
I think the first angle is greater than the second angle.
But I think both these angles are the same.
Look, kids, to guess any angle, we should look carefully at the curve formed between the arms. The greater the distance between the sides of the angle, the greater the angle. If we look at these angles carefully, the distance between their arms looks the same. To find out which angle is greater, let's measure both these angles using a protractor. Look at this. Both the angles are more than 90 degrees and less than 120 degrees and are almost showing the same angle.
It means that both the angles are equal. Thank you, uncle. Now we'll never make a mistake while identifying the measurement of angles.
In this video, we learned that in order to measure the angle, we need to align the center point of the protractor and the vertex of angle, and the arm of the angle has to be aligned with the baseline of the protractor. We also learned that if we want to find out the estimation of any angle, then we should pay attention to the distance between its arms. While measuring and identifying angles, you must take these points into consideration. Thank you.